happen to be visiting this morning with our friends Dr. Eboya Mesesh and Mesesh Laszlo. And our conversation got into talking about teaching at LL. And Eboya has been a teacher for us in LL Ministries in Eastern Europe at the Hungarian base for a number of years, and has been instrumental in our ministry into this nation, the nation of Hungary. And as our conversation got on, she began to talk of something about teaching about communism, and she began to tell us a story. And so I said, well, why don't we just put this on video, and so everyone could share and hear what she has to say about what's come out of this book on communism. So let's. I'm going to ask now Eboya just to tell her story.
So when Ato left Hungary, I was asked to teach this subject, communism. And it had two reasons, because I am old enough to have personal experiences about communism. I used to live more than 40 years under the communist regime, so I know what it means. And the other reason is that I know Ato also, and I have been there when he has written this book, so I knew his ID. And I have taught this subject, communism, in the Magyula school last October also. And it has happened a few very marvelous things that I want to share with you. I was thinking, after 60, 70 years happening this in Hungary, do they have any effect on the lives of the people? Why shall we teach this? And this last Magyula school has overcome that, yes, it has effect on the life of the people. And to begin the story, you have to know that about a few months ago, last August, five people invited us to a little village not far from Miskolc. And this village is a very nice village among the mountains, and it has a tiny Baptist church, only 12 members. And five of them visit the LL Magyula school, and they have invited us into this tiny village. And we were thinking, nevertheless, the visit, the meeting was very blessed. Why are we are here, God? What is your reason to minister in this tiny village? Nevertheless, the meeting was fully packed. And I understood the answer of God in October when I thought about the subject of communism. And teaching the subject after that, always we give opportunity to the feedbacks. And one of the ladies cried very much, and she came forward and explained her story. She is from this little village not far from Miskolc, and she belongs to this tiny Baptist church. And she said that in the upstand in 56, 20 people from the village have been arrested, and five of them have been executed. And these five have been from the Baptist Church. Also, from the Baptist Church have been five martyrs for the communism. And one of them was her grandfather. And she was crying and weeping, telling us that this whole thing has influenced their complete life. The father became a very bitter person, that his father died, and they grew up in a big poverty, because everything was taken away from the family by the government, so they could keep only the house and nothing else. And the father became a very bitter person that the childhood was stolen away, and the granddaughter had a very bitter life also because the whole events as a curse have been upon the life of the family, and this curse have been upon the life of the church also, because five members of the church have been executed. And when this lady shared this story before the whole course, she asked, okay, I understood that that is the root of our problem, but you said I have to forgive, but whom shall I forgive in this case? And I asked him, do you know who has given the name of your grandfather to the secret police? Who has betrayed us, actually? And she said, yes, I know, our neighbor. Okay, then probably you should forgive first your neighbor. Our neighbor, she is furthermore our neighbor since nearly 60 years. And every day we met each other, I know in his eyes that he did these horrible things against our family. And I have to forgive him. Yes, you have to forgive this neighbor. Oh, it's so hard. And who else shall I forgive? And I try to explain. Probably you have to forgive the judge who has brought this sentence upon your grandfather. And who else? Probably the person who has executed your grandfather. And we try to find all these people who are in this story and needed to be forgiven. And she did, in the presence of the whole Majula school, weeping and crying. And after her testimony, a lot of people stood up and began to tell us stories, what has happened in their family, how the communism has affected their life, and who have been executed, who have been arrested in their family, and what has happened. And after 60 years, I was just shocked how many stories came up, and the people were just crying and weeping and forgiving all those people. And back to this story, it's important the day when we have made this teaching. It has happened in the 25th of October, and you have to know that the upstand in 56 started in 23rd October. So in 23rd October, 2 days before this Majula school, it's always a big celebration in Hungary. And in this village, the people erected a memorial pylon for those people who have been executed. And the whole village gathers at these days, and they speak about how horrible things happened in this village, and they speak about those five executed persons as heroes. And for the family, it's always a wound, and always a big, deep wound. And with a fresh wound, this lady came to the meeting 2 days later. And she understood that that is the main problem. And she said, next year, shall I go to this memorial pylon at all? And shall I put down flowers for my grandfather or not? Or what shall I do next time? Because there is always a wound if we remember of this problem. So the end of this story is that that the bitter father became very sick, and the father nearly died, but in his life he couldn't forgive anybody. And the daughter, after this meeting, could explain him what he has to do, and he could finally forgive, and he died within few months, but reconciled. And the other thing is, since this forgiveness happened in the Majula school, the church began to grow. and not a big grow, but began to happen something after so many years.
So thank you, Iboya, for your message. It was a good testimony to discover how the spirit of communism was working, coming down three generations. And what we see is that God is past time, past generations, and he can reach into any point in our lives and bring his healing power. God bless you.